Good morning, everybody. Tammy here, and I have a new share for Anna White's series, hashtag Snowmen of January. And I want to show you first which stamp I chose to use. He is a little Hero Art stamp. Let's see, what is he called? Jumbo Snowman. There's not a year. Oh, yes, there is. I think, oh dear. I do this every time I start a video. Let me get my glasses in case you want to look for him. He is from 1994. So this is who I used. And I turned him into this little card. And I was going for like a 1950s vintage snowman look. I can remember my grandparents having snowman figurines very similar to this with these colors, and so I wanted to kind of replicate the antique-y looking, you know, light pink flocked tree, and using the teal and the pink for his scarf and then his little headband. Of course I used Copic markers. And let's see, I used in addition, well, let's finish with the card and then I'll show you what I used. So I used a few different paper collections to come up with my little layers here. I used some of the Nouveau, these are the glitter drops, excuse me, to do the sparkly snow. And then, like I said, the flocking on the tree. But I also used Anna White's little glitter tip that she's given all of us. It's so I put the glitter drops down, you know, how I want them. And then I sprinkle the ultrafine glitter on top of it. And oh my gosh, it gives it such a shine and a shimmer. So I am loving using her little tip about the glitter. Having so much fun. I kind of stayed away from glitter for a while, but not anymore. It's fun to use. So the little embellishment up here in the corner is some 100% silk ribbon in this little pretty blue color, and then some fibers that are super soft, just like the ribbon. And all of these, the ribbon and the fibers, I've purchased from a crafty friend. Her name is Becky Swartzlander. She's on YouTube and she has sales every now and then, and I'm going to do a haul of things that I've bought from Becky because her items are amazing and I love to use them to craft with. So, and then this was just a little Brad I had in my stash. I thought the Brad went well with the sparkly pink. And I think this is from a Bow Bunny collection of Brads. And then these little sequins are actually sequins I bought from Becky. And I used, again, a little spot of this under each sequin. And it just adds that extra little bit of sparkle. So I think I'm going to start doing that instead of using like the glitter glue. And it's holding them very well, so I don't think I have to worry about them falling off. So, and then I use some of my normal dies that I use for card making. This stitched rectangle die, and then I actually fussy cut the little snowman in the tree out. I had stamped it on some the white cardstock that I like to use that Anna recommended. It's amazing how your Copics lay down on that paper. It's the Nina. Nina, I'll link the paper because she had done a video on her papers that she uses. So, and it really does make a difference to me, I've found, using the Nina brand. And I just can't remember what it's called right now, but I will put it in the description box. But anyway, so I fussy cut the little snowman out and then laid him on this paper, which gave me a great background. And I'll show you the collection in a minute. But inside, it's just really simple. I just use a little stamp. And I love these little stamps. They are, there's like, gosh, 20 or 25 in the set. And what's right here? They're from Dots. And I had scored this little stamp set from an auction house close to where I'm at. So, yeah, I just thought that looked so cute. It just says peace, joy, love. And then the back, I actually added this is a little snowman from that same set that I used the sentiment from. And so I just stamped him next to my handcrafted by stamp. And I think it was Anna that was talking about different ways to sign your cards. And I love the little idea of adding a little stamp, that kind of signifies you, your interest. Or you can use a stamp that coordinates with the style of card or the theme. So that's what I chose to do with the little snowman. So that's my number four card in the series. And it was a lot of fun to make. So the paper collections that I did use were okay, this is by Craft O'Clock and it's called Frosty. And you know what's funny? Frosty Sparking. I don't know if that's supposed to say sparkling, but it says Frosty Sparking. So I guess that's right. It's a really cute paper collection and it has all sorts of great little papers to use, you can see for backgrounds. And look at the cozy little hot cocoa. So yeah, it's got a ton of cute things. This is from, where is Craft O'Clock from? I think it might be from Poland. Yes, Poland. Okay. And then I also used the Studio Light. This is called Winter Days. I love this little paper pad, and I have the big one as well. Let's see, the pink. The pink came out of this pad. And this has, you don't have to use some of this paper for winter, although it's all very, very cute. So, used to that one. And then I also used for the very background, the beige, I found some sheet out of this. And I think this is called Maja Designs. Called Christmas Season. And they are out of Sweden, I believe. Yeah. And this is a big, what I like about their little collections, the 6x6, you get a ton of paper and it's double-sided and lots of fun prints. So the beige at the background and on the inside is from this paper collection. So, and then I also used my Wink of Stella, the glitter white. I used this all over my little snowman after I had colored him. And just a word of caution, I forgot how these work when you push the button and you're over your project. Oh my gosh, I didn't think enough was coming out as I was coloring around in his little body. I pushed this button and oh my gosh, you guys, I had two big glops puddles drop onto him. So after I panicked for a second, I just started kind of brushing it around and it was way too much, so I had to mop it up with a paper towel. But you know what? It actually gave him kind of an aged antique-y look because it kind of blended some of the Copic colors and faded them in an antique-y kind of way. So it all worked out. And then I just touched up his buttons again. I think I used the black sparkly Spectrum Noir brush marker for his buttons and his little eyes. And then for his the little berries on his hat, I used the Nuvo Crystal Drops. And this is called Autumn Red. And a trick that I use, which I'm sure everybody that uses these Nuvo drops regularly, I did each berry separately. I did one and then I let it dry probably for a good hour. You know, I kind of tapped it a little bit to make sure it was dry. And then I did the second berry so that they didn't kind of meld together if you try to do them at the same time because they're so close. So I did the three little berries, each one separately, and allowing about an hour between each to dry before, you know, putting another one on. And then this little thing, oh my gosh, I don't know what I've done without this. The Stamp-a-Majig. I love this for your wooden stamps to be able to, you know, do two, three images if you have to, print, you know, imprints. It's a lifesaver. So I found this on eBay. I think I talked about it in my last video, but I can't believe how, even to do the sentiment on the inside, just to make sure you're centered. And you can do more than one image if you need to, and it's perfect. It allows for perfect placement. So, love this little thing. And then what else? Okay, here's my little handmade stamp I use. And I'm looking around. I think that's it. I think that is all of the products that I used. This was a fun little card to make. And again, I think this just shows that don't look at the colors that they use on the stamps, particularly if it's not to your liking. Think outside the box, because I've turned down a lot of wooden stamps, and I know Marilyn G. I talked about this in one of her videos, and it was eye-opening to me, because I was guilty of, if I saw this stamp sitting on a shelf, you know, in a store, I would be like, no, I don't like it, because I don't like the colors that they used. But look at what you can turn it into. You can totally make it yours. Whatever style, if you like shabby, if you like vintage, bold colors. So when you're looking at, for stamps on Facebook Marketplace or eBay, keep that in mind, because it really is a game changer as to what stamps you can build in your collection. So I just thought I would add that. I know Marilyn has talked about it, but it is so true. So give you one more look at him. I'm really happy with how he turned out. And I'm going to be creating more. I have a long weekend that I'm going to. I have to do grocery shopping and stuff like that and some cleaning. But I plan to be in my craft room for most of the day today and tomorrow. So I'm going to get some more cards done and be sure to share them. And thank you again, Anna. This series is so much fun. It's so much fun to keep our winter, you know, holiday stuff out and keep using it through the month of January. So until next time, thank you everybody so much for watching, and I will talk to you later. Bye-bye.